Hello everybody, E here. Welcome back to another book review. Today we are talking about Alan Baxter's The Rue. Before we get started, I'm going to tell you the story of how this book came to be, because I love stories like this, especially when Twitter comes together and creates something awesome. I'm going to read the very first part of the foreword. There's no spoilers here, but the foreword, or A Killer Kangaroo Story. Are you serious, Baxter? That's what it says. That's not me saying that. It says, A Killer Kangaroo Story. Are you serious, Baxter? This all started with a ridiculous situation on Twitter. There was a news article going around with the headline, Australian Town Terrorized by Muscular Kangaroo Attacking People and Eating Gardens. That was shared, and Keelan Patrick Burke, who did the cover, that cover is amazing, but he did the cover, he did a mock-up, a joke cover, and posted it into that thread, and Alan Baxter saw it, and him being Australian, everybody cajoled him into writing the book, and he took it on, and then Keelan, he asked Keelan if he could use the cover. Keelan, fixed the cover, but he gave more detail, he just really polished it, and then he allowed Alan to use it. I love books that come about because of things like this, and this book is absolutely batshit crazy and so much fun. Another thing that I enjoyed was, if you are a part of the horror community on Twitter, horror book community, you're going to recognize numerous names in here. Stephen Gomsey, Sadie Hartman, Mindy Snyder, the list goes, Tracy Robinson, the list goes on and on and on. I think every single main character is based off someone in the horror book community. So it was very interesting to see. Now, they're not, the people that they're named after, the characters that are named after them are nothing like these people. Some of them are utterly vile, some of them are just terrible people, but and some of them share the same look, like Jim McLeod from Ginger Nuts of Horror is a big burly ginger with the big ginger beard, and Shane Keen looks like himself. Shane Douglas Keen, he is a book reviewer for I think he is the sole book reviewer for Shotgun Logic. All these people I know, it was fun to watch them, you know, get torn apart by this giant kangaroo. Somebody, Laird, this is probably going to quote me, it was fun to watch my friends get torn apart. Anyways, but it was fun seeing how Baxter, you know, got through the cast, and, you know, tearing, ripping, shredding, all kinds of stuff. There is one death in here, the death of Brennan LaFaro, who is a horror author himself. That is the funniest death scene I have read all year. Talk to the hands, mate. Anyways, but it was, I don't want to spoil it for you. Go in blind with this one. It did have very heavy Pumpkinhead of the movie Pumpkinhead vibes. Also, if you're a fan of not exploitation cinema, but like creature features that don't aren't too deep, they're just a lot of fun. What it reminded me of the most was, I think it's The Boar, that was on Shudder, about the semi-truck-sized boar that terrorizes this small outback community. If you're a fan of things like that, you're going to love this one. The kangaroo is, it is a bit menacing, but mostly it's hilarious, because you're just the many different ways that Alan was able to just destroy people in this, with this demonic kangaroo. It's over 7 feet tall. It's got these huge talons. In fact, he tells you in the foreword, if you don't know what a kangaroo's feet look like, definitely check it out. I went and looked it up, and I don't ever want to meet a kangaroo. I especially don't want to meet one after this. I know kangaroos box, and, you know, they're beating people up all the time. But this story is just a whole lot of fun. If you're looking for something to break the monotony of, you know, serious literature, but it's still well written, and you know, just if you're looking for something fun, this is definitely where you need to go. So I'm giving it a full 5 stars, because some books you read for education and literature purposes, and you know, you want a deep emotional experience, and some books you just read because they're batshit crazy and just brings you utter joy to read. And this book was an utter joy for me to read. But have you read I almost said The Outback. Have you read The Rue by Alan Baxter? If you have, let me know down there in the doobly-doo whether or not you loved it, you hated it, felt meh about it. But if you felt any of those things, please let me know in detail why, so that we can have a discussion. But until next time, I have been E, you have been you, this has been another book review. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye!